Amen. Let me ask my wife to say thank you to all and greet you.
Provisions. Thank you for the organizations. Thank you for the way you organize things by your mighty hand. Thank you for divine protection of every one of us. Thank you for your counsel. Thank you for your word. Oh, we can only give you a clap of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We ask that your word will come to us expressly with understanding. In Jesus' glorious name we pray. Amen.
Amen. We can take our seats. Amen. Yesterday when our sister Amanda was teaching,
Nezuro Amaedu Amanda Pai Paridza,
she had three glasses. Three glasses here. A small one, a medium one, and a little bit bigger one. When the water was put in,
Mvura payakadirwa mukati.
All of them were full.
Ose akazadzwa.
But they had different capacities.
Asi aigona kutakura zvakasiyana.
All of them were full to the brim.
Ose akazadzwa kuchechetera.
But they had different capacities. The amount of water in each one of them was different.
Aitakura zvakasiyana, mvura yanga yakawanda zvakasiyana maari.
And we were taught that there needs to be a stretching.
Tikadzidziswa kuti panofanira kuva nekutatamuka.
But how do you become a bigger glass from a smaller one?
Unosvika seiko pakuva kapu yakakura kubva pakuvadiki?
That's what I want to talk about this morning.
Ndozvandoda kutaura nezvazvo mangwanana.
Opening doors of growth.
Kuzarura masuo ekukura.
Let's go to the book of 2 Kings chapter 6.
Ngatiendei kubhuku yamadzimambo echipiri chitsauko 6.
2 Kings chapter 6.
Madzimambo echipiri chitsauko 6. 2 Madzimambo 6.
He says, the sons of the prophets say to Elisha, see, now the place where we dwell with you is too small for us.
Zvino vanakomana vaprofita vakati kuna Erisha, tarirai zvino apa patigere pamberi penyu pakamanikana, hapatiringani.
We'll come back to that scripture, but let's go to the book of Joshua 17.
Tichadzoka zvakare pandima iyi, ngatiendei kuna Joshua chitsauko 17.
The book of Joshua chapter 17.
Joshua chitsauko 17.
From verse 14 to 18. He says, then the children of Joseph spoke to Joshua, saying, why have you given us only one Lord and one share to inherit, since we are a great people, inasmuch as the Lord has blessed us until now?
Zvino vana vaJosefa vakataura naJoshua vakati, makatipireiko mugove mumwe chete nechikamu chimwe chete kuti ive nhaka yedu zvatiri vanhu vazhinji, nokuti Jehovha wakatiropafadza kusvikira zvino.
So Joshua answered them, if you are a great people, then go up to the forest country and clear a place for yourself there in the land of the Perizzites and the giants, since the mountains of Ephraim are too confined for you.
Joshua akati kwavari, kana muri vanhu vazhinji, endai henyu kudondo mundozvitemera nzvimbo ipapo panyika yavaperezi nevarefaimi zvamusingakwaniri panyika yamakomo yaEfraimi.
But the children of Joseph said, the mountain country is not even enough for us, and all the Canaanites who dwell in the land of the valley have chariots of iron, but both those who are in Bethshean and its town and those who are in the valley of Jezreel.
Vana vaJosefa vakati, nyika yamakomo haingatikwaniri, uye vaKanani vose vanogara munyika yomupata vane ngoro dzamatare, ivo vose vari paBhetishiani nemisha yaro navari mumupata weJezireeri.
Verse 17, and Joshua spoke to the house of Joseph, to Ephraim and Manasseh, saying, you are a great people and have a great power. You shall not have only one Lord.
Zvino Joshua akataura neveimba yaJosefa, ivo vaEfraimu navaManase akati, iri mbipuri vanhu vazhinji, mune simba guru, hamungavi nomugove mumwe chete.
But the mountain country shall be yours, although it is wooded. You shall cut it down, and its farthest extent shall be yours. For you shall drive out the Canaanites, though they have iron chariots and are too strong.
Asi nyika yamakomo ichava yenyu, nokuti kunyange riri dondo muchafanira kuritema, mabudiro aro ose agova enyu, nokuti munofanira kudzinga vaKanaani kunyange vane ngoro dzamatare uye kunyange vane simba.
In the two scriptures,
mundima mbiri dzataverenga,
there is a complaint.
Pane kuchema chema.
The space is too small for us.
Zvimbo yedu yamanikana.
The sons of Joseph are complaining to Joshua.
Vana vaJosefa vari kuchema kuna Joshua.
They are saying, we are a great people.
Vanoti isu tiri rudzi rukuru.
But you have given us a very small portion.
Asi iwe uri kutipa nzvimbo diki kwazvo.
And Lord, Joshua says, look, go and take more land.
Joshua, what did you end up in the Torah?
He says, if you are a great people,
what kind of machine do you want to
do? Then go ahead and take the land. They still come back and say, no, the mountain country is not even enough for us. And the conversation goes on. I don't know if you have ever looked at the map of inheritance of the nation of Israel when the tribes settled.
And this is the Magambotarisa, Pananizuinika, Naka, Yakapuana, Israel, Yakagara.
You know, the tribe of Manasseh by census was the always the smallest.
I think in
the first census, they were just a little bit above
32,000.
Judah was the most populous. I think Judah was above 76,000.
But
in terms of occupation of land, half of Manasseh inherited the land in Bashan, on the other side of the
Jordan.
And on this side of the Jordan, they stretched from almost Beth Shean on the east, almost to the coast. But here they are saying we need more land. The space is not for us. But there is a challenge. Both for them and Ephraim, the tribe of Joseph, they're saying, but the place you are giving us has giants. In the book of 2 Kings 6, the sons of the prophet say to Elisha, the place is too small.
We
have outgrown this place. We need to grow. And I want to submit to you that as I've been in this conference, in the way that God has been speaking to us, it simply means to my heart that God is saying, you need to grow. You know, in Romans 5, 15, actually. 15, not 5.
But Romans 15.
Paul says there is no more space for us. We have preached the gospel from Jerusalem to Illyricum. He says everywhere. Now there is no more room for us here. We need to go further. I pray that you will go further. From this conference, you will go further. Because if you want greater capacity to do more, to have the 5 talents, so that you can get the 5 talents, you need to increase your capacity. You increase capacity by growing. If you don't grow, there is no capacity that has increased. Now let's go back to the book of 2 Kings and learn a few principles from there. From the sons of the prophets. So growth usually mostly happens in 2 ways. You either increase in size, that means quantity, or you increase in strength.
or you expand and grow in scope, in capacity, in influence. So the sons of the prophet says, look, the place is small. So they say, verse
2,
please let us go to the Jordan and let every man take a beam from there and let us make there a place where we may dwell. So he answered, go. So they said, we want to grow. Elisha says, then go.
Elisha gawati na zimwa endai.
So the first thing, if we want to grow, we must take an initiative. We must act.
Saka chokutanga kana uchida kukura, unofanela kusimuka, uona cha unoita.
He said, let us arise.
Anotinga disimuke.
And go to the Jordan.
Toinda kuchorodani.
It was at a distance, the forest. It was at Jordan, next to the river. These guys are up, maybe near Gilgal. They want to go, he says, go to the forest.
And
many people want to grow, they think about growth, they imagine growth, they do nothing about it. You need to move. You know, I think it's in the book that Bonke wrote something about fire. He gives an example in that book about the Holy Spirit. Using an old steam engine. You know, there was a time the trains used steam to be fired for them to move. So he says in those days, whatever firewood you're using, firewood or coal or whatever they use coal in those engines, you would come and boil the water. And then it will make this hot water will release steam.
Gear.
And the steam will go to the horn. And then it will make noise. Pop! So it announces the train is about to move.
chitima chakuda kuchisimuka
zvino. And then he would lower the next one.
Oba dzikisa rimwe gear.
And the steam will go into the engine.
Chiudzi chomhanya chichipinda.
And the train will start moving.
Chitima chotanga kufamba kuenda mberi.
He says many Christians have lowered only the first gear.
Zvino ma Kristu mazhinji akangodzikisa gear rokutanga roruzha bedzi.
They are shouting, shaka ya bala bala bala.
Oba vaita zvendimi dzokuputika chete.
No movement.
Apana kufambira mberi.
Shaka ya bala 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 bala.
No movement.
Oputika nendi.
Shaka ya bala 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 bala.
Kwa 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 kwa.
God is moving in this place.
Vari vari kufamba muzvimbo ino.
But they are stationary. In the train station.
Vachingori panzvimbo imwe chete.
Please, I have come to tell you, leave the station.
Ndauya ndapota hama dzangu ndauya kuzotaura kuti simuka kubva pachiteshi.
Start moving.
Tanga kufamba.
Growth will happen. Growth will happen.
Uchazoitika ipapo.
When you start moving.
Paunotanga kufamba uchienda.
Stay, the place is small.
Taura kuti nzvimbo.
We are going to the Jordan to cut the trees.
Kuenda kuJorodhani kunotema miti.
If we do nothing, nothing happens.
Kana usina chawaita hakuna chinoitika kwauri.
He says in that verse 2,
anoti pandima ya 2,
I want you to look at the action where it says, let us go to the Jordan.
Ndoda kuti muone zvakanyorwa kuti vaiti vanoti handei kuJordan.
That's number 1.
Ndoche kutanga.
Number 3 says, let every man take a beam from there.
Chechipiri panonzi, murume mumwe nomumwe ngaatore danda kubva ipapo.
We sit on the table to eat food. All of us sit, we can sit on a big table.
Don't say you're not going to go to the table,
but each one of us must do their growing alone.
He says, let every man take a
beam.
Growth is not corporate.
We grow corporately when every individual is growing.
Tinokura seboka kana mumwe nomumwe wedu achikura.
If you grow as a person and one part of your body doesn't grow, you have a lameness.
Kana ukakura nhengo imwe chete yemuviri ichingokura, unoremara.
He says, let every man.
Zvinonzi murume mumwe nomumwe.
And I say, let every man and woman in this place.
Take their own responsibility for growing.
Ngatore azvipe basa rekuti akure.
Even in a family,
kunyange muri mumhuri,
you can only give food to your children, you can't grow them.
Unogona chete kungopa vana vako chikafu asi hauvakudziwe.
God has designed they have to go and sleep and do their growing.
Mwari wakazvironga kuti vanofanira kunovata votanga kukura ivo pachavo.
Nobody is going to do your growing from here.
Hakuna achazokura akakumiririra.
You will need to individually do things that make you grow.
Iwe homene uchafanira kuita zvinhu.
He says, every man go and cut your beam.
Munhu mumwe nomumwe ngaaende anotenga.
We want to build the house.
Toda kuvaka imba.
But not every man.
Asi munhu nomumwe.
Take a beam.
Ngaaudze danda.
You know, we wanted to build a house. And we were trusting God for money to build that house.
And the money was not coming.
One day my wife said, let's go to the place where we want to build and let every child believe God for their room.
No, mudzimai wangu ati handei kunzvimbo yatinoda kunovakira. Takamira ipapo mwana mumwe nomumwe ngaapinde naMwari.
When
tawana kamurira.
When you finish praying, we will pray for the things we will share, the living room and the kitchen.
Kana tapedza kunamata, tozonamatira zvinhu zvatinogovana chese, kitchen ne dining room.
God for your room, believe God yourself.
Asi kana uchida woimba yerumu inozonzi yako, namatira iyoyo kunamata.
Tell your friend, every man or woman is big.
Tell them,
go and cut yours.
challenge of the church in Africa is that we depend so much on preachers.
Dambudziko guru ratinaro sekereke muAfrica ndeyekuti takazendamira kunyanya pavaparidzi.
We think they will do our growing.
Tinofunga kuti vachatiitira zvose kunyange kutokura vakatimiririra.
We boast so much which churches we go, not how much we read the Bible and grow.
Tobatanzwa manyawu wokuti ini ndiriko oka vagatsi ndinopinda kuchechi yakati kwete kuverenga Bhaibheri.
Thank God for WhatsApp. Nowadays we have a scripture for the day.
Pano to uyawo verse inotumirwa zuva rimwe nerimwe,
which you receive from your friends.
Yaunogamuchira kubva kushamwari dzako.
And when you read it, you feel you have read the Bible.
Paunenge waiverenga unonzwa kuti hanhu hasi ndaverenga Bible.
You can go through the day by the verse of the day.
Unobva watofamba zuva rese uchiraramiswa nevhesi imwe yezuva iro.
By the way, they have also not read it.
Munoziva ivo vakutumira pamwe havana kutoeverenga.
Just saw it and forwarded it.
Vakangoiona nobva vangokutumira.
It hasn't even gone through them.
Haina kutombopfuura nomavari.
Says something more.
Inotaura zvimwe pamberi.
He says, and let us make it there a place where we may dwell. Sometimes it requires change of location. Sometimes it requires moving out of the familiar.
Nedzimwe nguva zvinoda kubuda muzvinhu zvakajairika.
Sometimes it requires you to move out of what you have gotten used to and what you can always navigate very easily.
Nedzimwe nguva zvinodawo kuti ubve pane zvakajairika zviri nyore kwauri.
Sometimes you need to break the boundaries of what you have achieved for you to grow.
Nedzimwe nguva unoda kuti udarike miganhu yezvawakagona zvawakakunda.
You know, one of your biggest organ in the body. I don't know how we can explain it, an organ or a tissue. It's your skin. It has the biggest surface area. It is the one that grows most. Because it has to cover you. And it has to regenerate every day to cover you. It has to grow all the time. And renew itself all the time. Because it has to accommodate every change that comes on your body. That's how you ought to grow. If your skin remains growing, you will bust. Even if it's not a spiritual relocation, sometimes you need a spiritual redeployment. So that you can grow. You do things that you have not done. You go to your desired levels, you haven't come to. Sometimes you even challenge. Challenges everything around you. It questions the things that you have done and how you have done them. Grow means you're breaking into new frontiers. That you have never come before. Maybe you learn something new. Maybe you consider learning a trade or starting a program or reading a book. You know, something you see from this process of growth.
chinhu chatinoona nebasa nechiitiko chekukura panhauya vana vavaprofita.
They were willing to work with their own hands to see that growth.
Vakanga vakazvipira kushanda nemaoko avo kuti vasvike pakukura.
They were willing to say, look, let's go.
Vakanga vakazvipira kuti Jesu.
The only thing they asked the prophet, say, please go with us.
Chinhu chimwe chavakangokumbira muranda wamwari ndechekuti tapota endai nesu.
Anyway, they went.
Asiwo vakaenda, vaiti kwese kwavanoenda.
Then they came to the Jordan.
Pavakasvika kuJorodhani.
Verse 5.
Pandima ya 5.
He says, but as one was cutting down a tree, the iron axe fell into the water. And he cried out and said, alas, master, it was bald.
Asi mumwe wakati achitema danda chese ndokuwira mumvura akadanidzira achiti haiwa tenzi wangu nokuti rakanga rakumbirwa.
Sometimes we borrow things so that we grow.
Nedzimwe nguva tinokumbira kana kukwereta zvinhu kuti tikure.
And that's okay.
Zvakanaka zvina
kuti. I want you to know they won't last.
Ndoda kuti muzive kuti hazvizogari nekusingaperi.
Borrowed things will not last.
Zvinhu zvokukwereta zvokukopa hazvigari nguva nokusingaperi.
Borrowed things have their own challenges.
Zvinhu zvokukwereta zvine matambudziko azvo.
We can borrow things so that we grow.
Tinogona kukumbira zvinhu kuti ti.
But that can only be for a time.
Zvinogona kungova.
We can borrow methods.
Unogona kukopa maitire.
We can borrow strategies.
Ogona kutokopawo.
They will work for a moment.
Zvinogona kushanda kwechimba.
But there comes a time you need your own axe for you to cut down the tree.
Panozosvika nguva yaunoda zvinobva mauri zvawapiwa iwe kuti ugorarama nguva refu.
But these sons of the prophets were good people.
Asi ava vana vakomana vavaprofita.
Even the borrowed one.
Kunyange zvanga zvakumbirwa.
They looked after it.
Vakazvichengetedza.
When it fell and got lost.
Pachakarashika kushayikwa.
They cried to the prophet to recover it.
Chema kumuprofita kuti chidzoke zvakare.
If it was you and me, say, we would tell the person it got lost.
Dai wanga uri weneni waiti pamunjangorumudza kuti tachishayiwa.
Darashik growth requires stewardship even of borrowed things.
Kukura kunoda kuti ugone kuchengetedza kubata zvakanaka kunyange zvakumbirwa.
If you can't look after things of other people, you can't grow.
Kana ukasagona kuchengeta zvinhu zvavamwe haugoni kuti ukure.
They had a borrowed axe.
Vane demo rakanga rakwera.
It fell into the water and got lost.
Rakapinda rikarasikira mumvura.
But they cried for it.
Asi vakachema kudzoswa kwaro.
But further on I've already said that you need your axe for you to grow.
Asi unoda demo rako kuti ugone kukura.
You need your own axe that you can use to cut down trees.
Unododa demo rako rokuti ushandise kutema matanda.
So that we can grow.
Kuti tigone kukura.
God cared so much that even when they cried out about the axe, he was able to bring it back.
Mwari vaiva nehanya navo zvokuti pavakachemera demo iri rakaita kuti ridzoswe ridzoke mumaoko avo.
Friends, you know the purpose of that capacity and growing is not just enlargement.
Hama dzangu, chinangu aurovavariro yekukura iyi hakusi kungotatamurwa bedzi.
Remember I said that we grow in size.
Tataura kuti tinokura pamutumbi.
But the quality of growth is that capacity is there to do things.
Asi nyaya yekukura iyi ine uremu hunoita uchigone kuita zvinhu.
That second level of growth brings maturity.
Icho chiyero chechipiri ichichi chekukura chinoita chinounza kuyaruka.
You see, if you grow by years,
kana ukangokura makore bedzi,
and by size,
nemutumbi nomuturu wako,
but you don't mature,
asi usingayarukiwo pamaitiro,
you should have resolved our problem.
Panogona kuva nedambudziko ipapo.
We say, oh no, but the guy is big, but he behaves like a child.
Ona kuti, ah, munhu uyu zvaanomutumbi mukuru asi inenge pwere.
That is not a compliment.
Hakusi kupembedzwa ipo.
You have grown in size.
the sons of the prophet. It's not enough to have a bigger place. God must mature us to have the maturity to handle the responsibility of a bigger school. That's why sometimes we have people in leadership positions. But the children, they cannot handle inheritance. They cannot look up for nation. Because they're children. They don't have maturity to handle a nation. To handle a congregation. Because haven't grown there. I want you to pray and go home and mature. Do things that will bring growth. Training ourselves in the word of God, in how we carry the responsibility. Of course, for that quality of growth, the Bible tells us in the book of John 15, which we will not read, that for quality growth to happen, there needs to be pruning. And you need to know how to prune. We have a farm, we have about 320
oranges
called pixies. They're just young, they are growing. And so I got somebody to train the workers to prune. And so they had never done it on their own. So the guy came once and disappeared.
And
so it took so long and they were going out. I mean, it was getting late. And I asked them, are you sure? They said, because I wasn't going to be there, I was traveling, it was taking time too. I asked them, are you sure you saw it well, you can do it? They said, yes, we will do it. They did it and I went after about 2 weeks. It was a disaster. It was a disaster. They had cut off all the tips. That is not
true.
I almost got a shock of my life. I had to actually look for foliar to spray them to sprout. And then come to do the training properly. But we need pruning. It's a painful process. You take off shoots and branches to open up the plant. So you have to know, why do you do pruning on a plant?
We
open it up for the sun's rays to reach every part, so that the air can flow in between and reduce things that will bring pests. So it's not good for a fruit-bearing tree, just to grow with all the foliar. Sometimes you need to take off.
Why?
We have a goal when we do pruning. What is the goal of pruning? It is not just for the sun.
I see here.
It is for fruitfulness. The whole of that process is to get that plant to bear much fruit. Growth is useless if it doesn't result in fruitfulness. Jesus did not complain about the tree if it had grown or not. What he was looking on it was fruit. You know, I should look at my life. Say, how much more am I bearing today than last year? How much more? That requires pruning that removes dead things from life. Dead things that are dead.
Zvinhu zvakafa ndozvinenge zvichibviswa.
And of course the tree bears fruit first of all by what it has.
Asi muti unotangawo kubereka zvibereko chekutanga nezvauinazvo.
You know, any gift that is not used, it naturally dies.
Chipo chimwe nechimwe chisingashandiswi chinotongopedzisira chafa.
You know those guys that run marathons from Kenya and do all this long distance running?
Munoona here vakomana ava munoona vanomhanya mijaho yakareba iyi vanobva kuKenya ukoko.
They rarely have more than a month in a year where they don't train.
Azviwanzi uoneka kuti vakwanise nguva inenge mwedzi pagore rese vasina kuita kunotraina kuzvidzidzisa.
They train all the time.
Nguva nenguva vanenge vachingoramba vakasimbirira ipapo vachidzidzisa miviri yavo
to keep themselves fit
kuti varambe vakati gwindiri
just to run for 2 hours
kuti vazomhanya chete kwamahawa maviri.
We want to grow.
Toda kukura.
But we want to grow so that we can bear fruit.
As toda kuti tikure, tigobereka zvibereko.
How much space do you have for operation today?
Une nzvimbo yakadiko yekushandira panguva ino.
God can grow it.
Mwari vanogona kuikura.
What is your horizon of operation?
Zviko zvauri kuona zvaunogona kuita.
I want you to begin to look and say it can be expanded.
Ndoda kuti utange kusimudza meso ako utange kutarisa.
I can rise.
Ndinogona kusimuka.
And go to the Jordan.
Ndoenda kuJordan.
And cut down a tree.
Ndotema miti ikoko.
And build the house.
Zobata imba.
And expand this work.
Ndokudza basa iri.
And bear more fruit.
Ndobereka zvibereko zvizhinji.
We need to expand.
Tinofanira kutata
into those open doors.
Kuti Mwari vachizarura masuo.
Yes, the area we may want to go into could be forested, like for the children of Joseph.
Ichokwadi nzvimbo yatinoda kusvika inogona kusava nyore riri dondo sevana vaJosepha.
Rarely do you go just and occupy, find an empty place and occupy.
Kashoma chaiko kaunogona kuda kubuda kuenda wongowana nzvimbo yakatocheneswa kare.
It may require to dislodge the people with chariots of iron.
Zvinogona kuda kuti utange urwise ukunde vanhu vane ngoro dzamatare.
It may require for you to cut down a forest.
Zvinogona kuda kuti uteme miti unate nzvimbo ubvise dondo riripo.
For you
kuti iwe ukure.
You know, dear brother,
hama dzangu,
the greatest need we have today is bearing fruit.
Chinhu chikuru chatinodisisa nguva ino kubereka zvibereko.
The greatest need we have today is a mature church.
Chinhu chikuru chatinoshuvira nguva ino chatinoda ikereke yayaruka pazvinhu zvaMwari.
That can take responsibility.
Inogona kugamuchira nokupiwa basa ichiriita nomazvo.
You know, you eat food in public. You grow in secret. We can't see you growing. We just notice that you have increased. Because you grow in the place of intimacy. In your sleep. Let's bow down to prayer. Is there anyone here who desires to go to the next level? You're saying the place where I am is small. God brought you to this conference to take you out of here so that you can go and do more. I just want you to pray. Desire it. See it. But go out of here and act. Let me just give you a minute to pray. Say, I want to be the bigger glass. But it can contain more. By faith, if you're there and you just want to grow into the next level, lift up your right hand, we're going to pray together. I want to grow. There's something more that God wants to do with me. There's something more that God wants to do with me. And Father, we thank you for the next season of our lives. As we come out of this conference, you have spoken so much to us. Just you, the way you spoke to Joshua in Joshua 13. He says, I know you're old, but there is still more land to be possessed. And Father, we just surrender to you, King of Glory. We have constricted ourselves in small places. We have satisfied ourselves with little objectives, with small goals. We have contented ourselves with just dwelling in a place. But this morning, you're saying you can go to the Jordan. You can go to the wooded country. You can go to the land with chariots and take more space for yourself there. And I pray this morning, Lord, help us. Minister to us that we will go out of here with a growth agenda, with an objective to grow, to new horizons, to new of ministry, of the discourse, of the word of the Lord in us, of the capacity of the Holy Spirit in us, Jehovah God. Because in the story of the woman who was in conversation with the Lord, she says, go borrow vessels and pour out the oil. It is as many as you have that you are willing to fill. And I pray, Father, increase my vessels. Please.
for pruning. Lord, I pray, take away the dead works. Take away the old and the unfruitful. Take away that which impedes fruitfulness out of our lives. That which limits us from bearing much fruit. Lord, we don't just want a lush foliar. We want more flowers that can bear more fruit. So Lord, we go out of here knowing that from this conference, you have opened doors of ministry. But Lord, we are praying for capacity. Lord, we are praying, Lord, that we will be men and women of responsibility. Every man a being. The Lord, the doors that you are opening, we will have the capacity, the character, Lord, to stand and to serve in the new day of open doors that you're giving us. Lord, I pray for every minister, every servant. Lord, let the hand of God be upon them. Lord, to new levels of ministry. To a new day of ministry. The Lord, we will go to the Jordan and cut a beam and grow. And Lord, we pray corporately to visit us and minister to us, our Father. And Lord, as we go back to our homes, to our churches, to our businesses, to our offices, let there be a visitation. And let that visitation be of growth and maturity. We thank you, Father, and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. That's what I'm coming out of from here. That my greatest need is to bear fruit. And I want to go and bear fruit. If you are going to remain the same, something is wrong. But I thank God that I've been challenged, that I have to increase the capacity. And I must go and remove anything that is hindering us. This thing of pruning. How much pruning is going on in your life? Because some of you, when we look at you, it is the same fruit in the world and it's also the same fruit in you. Because you are not pruning yourself. We need the Holy Spirit to help us. He said, this is not for you. Worldliness.
Yika.
Did you hear me?
Mandivai.
There is a lot of worldliness.
In
the church.
Mikereke.
Why? Because you don't want to prune yourself. For me, I'm crying out that Lord, can you keep me in your act? Because out there, the way things are changing out there, terrible. But in the ark, God is the only one who will help you. Is it
Queen Esther.
Di mambo kazi Esther.
When she was chosen.
Pa akasarudzwa.
She refused.
Akaramba.
Anything else.
Zvimwe zvose.
Extra.
Zvazvikuwedzere.
Except that woman, what he told her, she is the one that she accepted. Because they were going to come before the king. And the king was going to choose a wife. Let me tell you, refuse everything else except what the Holy Spirit tells you. My prayer is, you will allow the Holy Spirit to tell you, this is not for you. That is what we want to pray for. That the Holy Spirit is going to prepare you as a bride for the King of Kings. When last did you hear the Holy Spirit? Because most of us, we just want to go with the crowd. You cannot grow. May the Holy Spirit prune your life. Next time you come here, we are going to see the glory of God. Come on, somebody say amen. So I want us to pray. May you give the Holy Spirit permission to prune you. Because the Holy Spirit knows what is needed in heaven.
It
is the farmer who says, no, this is not good for you, this is not good for this. I am praying that the Holy Spirit will continue to speak to each one of us here. Are we ready to be pruned? Are we ready to be pruned? Who is going to prune you? The Holy Spirit. Can someone say amen?
Amen.
I tell you, every time the Holy Spirit has pruned me, the fruit has changed. The comments that I hear tell me that I am being pruned by the Holy Spirit. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
The Holy Spirit wants to prune you so that you can bear fruit that will bring glory. That's, I want us to pray. The greatest need we have here is to bear fruit that will bring glory to God. Some of us, the Holy Spirit will tell you, no more wearing this. This is not for the kingdom. You must be ready to say everything that you have recommended to me from here, so that I can bear fruit. How many are ready for the Holy Spirit? Please don't pray if you are not ready to allow the Holy Spirit. Already some of us here, the Holy Spirit has pruned us. We are going to see fruit. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Please, Holy Spirit, prune me. The way you speak, your language, even the way you behave, may My wife sometimes says, why do you speak like that?
Why do you speak like that?
Why do you speak like that? She's helping me. But sometimes I say, you can't say that to the Holy Spirit. Here I am, Lord. Through me. Are you ready for that prayer? Here I am, Lord. Through me. That I will bear fruit. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Because if it is my wife pruning me, I say, I don't want my wife to prune me. I want the Holy Spirit. May God help us. That you have been pruned in this conference. The open doors are here. Let's all stand. I just want you to pray.
Don't
let us look for open doors. As God is taking us to even huge doors. Stretching beyond limitation. Stretching beyond limitation. Which means you've been limited in bearing fruit. But
going
out there, Lord, to bear fruit. I want you to talk to the Holy Spirit. Tell him what you want to do. For me, I'm praying to the Holy Spirit. Prune me. Prune me. Because the pruning is in secret. Let us pray for the Holy Spirit to prune us. Father, I want to thank you. I want to thank you for this word that has come to me, Lord. Because, Father, I desire kutanga batosh ragada siburi andarabayondo. We need to increase our capacity. Farmer. He knows what he wants.
Did you hear me?
Mazviva,
the pruning is not up to you. The pruning is up to the owner, who is the Holy Spirit. Here I am, Lord. Prune me. Here I am, Lord. Prune my family. Africa needs to bear fruit.
Africa, you know,
Africa must allow the Holy Spirit.
As Africa, you know,
to prune us. I want us to pray. That God start with my family. Start with my family. Prune this. Then we are going to pray. The fruit that Africa is bringing out is a shame. If you look at our leaders, they need pruning. Did you hear me? They need pruning. So before we pray for our nation, for the Holy Spirit to prune, because when we have prayed today, by God willing, if we meet next year, the fruit must be different. The fruit must be different. Let's give the Holy Spirit permission to prune us. Prune your children. You children, allow the Holy Spirit just to prove you. And the difference is going to be
shifted.
I want us to pray these levels. Holy Spirit, I am allowing you to prove me. This conference has pruned us.
Conference, you know,
I have come out from here. I'm going home different. I don't know whether you have been
pruned
like me. But we want to pray for God to prune us and prune our family. Father, in the name of Jesus,
hallelujah,
we are praying now for pruning. Holy Spirit, prune your servants. Prune everything that needs to be pruned. Prune our language. Prune everything, oh God, that needs to be pruned. In the name of Jesus. Allah,
Psalm
138
and verse 8.
You have to pray with me. Can somebody say amen? It says, the Lord will fulfill his purpose for me.
Your
steadfast love, O Lord, endures forever. Do not forsake the work of your hands. In other version, he says, the Lord will perfect that which concerns me. Everything that concerns me, may God perfect. It is the farmer who comes and says, you don't need this, he cuts it off. Let us allow him to perfect that which concerns us.
Your behavior is going to change. Your way of doing things is going to change.
May God
perfect us. Father, we pray. Father, we pray that you will perfect that which concerns each one of us. We are leaving this conference. Lord, thank you for speaking to us. Thank you for stretching us. Thank you for allowing us to come before your throne of grace. I pray that you will perfect everything that which concerns every individual that came to this conference.
Hallelujah.
Perfect that which concerns us. Because the season to bear fruit is now.
Hallelujah.
Perfect that which concerns the continent of Africa. Perfect everything so that the glory comes back to you. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Please note, you can take your seat. Uncle Urban sent his teaching on, what do you call it? WhatsApp. And we will send it to you, then you can send it to different people in your group.
Hallelujah. Uncle Urban, what do you mean? I just chavo. The church to me, my WhatsApp groups, I see and I see and I don't know what to me. You want to me over.
So we are encouraging you, even what you have learned here, you know, you can go and share with other people. Send this message.
Friends. Hallelujah.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
So we want to thank God that the Lord has taken us this far. We want to thank God for our friends. It's not easy to get them to come here. But God is allowing them to continue to come and strengthen us. When you go back to your home, pray for your community.
And say,
Lord, perfect this which concerns this place. Move this place. I almost cried. Because I don't go to the city, you know. I rarely go. But this time I had to go. Because, I have, like my son, he says, no, you are not preaching in this. You must get something. So you organize for people to take me into town.
That's why
you can see how I'm looking. I'm being pruned. This is pruning. So I try to put on this and says, no. My son stands at the door and says, Dad, yeah.
He's there.
What's wrong with Dad? He's there. Okay, let me go in. And get
pruned.
So I went into doubt. What I saw, our city needs pruning. I'm telling you, that city used to be beautiful. But what I saw,
Not first district.
I thought my tomatoes are only
I used to think tomatoes are only sold in barren
season. A witch doctor is taking some sugar.
As in the one hand, I take some sugar in first district.
I hope. The city must be proved. Allowed to be proved. So in here I've allowed myself that, you know, when my son says, and my wife especially, she's a big pruner. She keeps on saying, ajite, ajite, you know.
What is wrong
with me? Ajite.
This one is not okay. It's not
please
okay.
Please cooperate with the pruners. Just cooperate with the pruners. When I cooperate with the pruners,
but you know, now,
it's the comments that people speak. Pastor, you're looking smart. Thinking that it's me. No.
What you know, genius, that's what
come on, somebody say amen.
Amen.
Allow the Holy Spirit to prune your community. To prune our country. To prune the continent of Africa. So we pray that as you go now, may you go in the peace of God. We are expecting you to be ambassadors of what happens with our open doors. We want to hear testimonies. Don't wait for next day, just send your testimony. We love you. We want to see you next day, God willing. We want you to keep on interacting with us. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Brother Axel.